So the next problem is calculate the following ratios from the given balance sheet. Current ratio, fixed assets to net worth ratio, debt equity ratio and return on capital employed. So these are the four ratios to be calculated, students. Current ratio, fixed assets to net worth, debt equity ratio and return on capital employed. So they have given you the balance sheet. So land, plant, machinery, investments, inventories, biz receivable, cash and bank, all these three are current assets and this is fictitious assets and this is fixed assets. And come to liability side of balance sheet, you have 600 shares of rupees 100 each, 60,000, general reserve, dividend equalization fund, long term loans, bills payable, provision for taxation, profit and loss account. So here itself I am going to discuss the shareholders funds. Shareholders funds include what? Share capital, general reserve, dividend equalization reserve and also profit and loss account. All these are the four items which comes under share capital. Long term loans is a long term debt and bills payable, then provision for taxes is a current liability. So with this information, now let us work out the problem. The first type of ratio is current ratio. Current ratio is equals to current assets divided by current liabilities. So current assets is 55,500 divided by 35,000, which is equal to 1.56:1. So what are the current assets you have? You have inventories, bills receivable and cash and bank. And current liabilities will be bills payable and provision for taxation. So substitute the values in the formula. So it is current assets divided by current liabilities, 55,500 divided by 35,000, which is equals to 1.56:1. When you are working out this problem, keep your Xerox copy of your problem sheet with you and then work out the problem. Then you have fixed assets to net worth ratio. So what is the formula? Fixed assets divided by net worth. So fixed assets, they are given in the problem. What are the fixed assets you have? So land, plant, machinery and investments. You add all these four, okay? So you will get 1,12,500. So share to net worth. What is other name for net worth? Shareholders funds. Students, I have already discussed what are shareholders funds. It includes what? Shareholders funds or net worth is equals to share capital plus general reserve plus dividend equalization reserve plus profit and loss account minus preliminary expenses. So this point you have to remember. So preliminary expenses is given in this problem. So how much is preliminary expenses? You have 8,000. Okay, when you are taking profit and loss, you have to take this previous year and current year balance of rupees 21,000. So substitute the values in the formula. You will get 0.99:1. Calculate debt equity ratio. So debt equity ratio is equals to long term debts divided by shareholders funds. So how much is long term debts? 20,000. In this problem you have only one long term debt, that is long term loans. So substitute the values in the formula, students. So how much is long term debts? 20,000 divided by shareholders funds. Shareholders funds is nothing but net worth, which we have already calculated. It is 1,13,000. So what is the ratio? 0.17:1. Now we'll move on to return on capital employed. So return on capital employed formula will be net profit before interest and tax divided by capital employed into 100. So they have given you net profit. How much is net profit? When you are calculating this, you take the net profit of the current year. So how much is the net profit of current year? 20,000. So 20,000 is the net profit. Plus to this you have to add into tax. Okay, why? Because we want net profit before interest and tax. So they have given you tax amount in the, on the liability side of balance sheet. How much is the tax amount? 5,000. So you will get 25,000. So what is this 25,000? Net profit before interest and tax. So 25,000 divided by capital employed. So I have already discussed while discussing the formulas that capital employed can be calculated under two approaches, that is asset based approach and liabilities based approach, which I am going to discuss now. So under liabilities approach, what is the formula for capital employed? Share capital, which includes equity share capital and preference share capital, plus general reserve, dividend equalization reserve, long term loans, plus profit minus preliminary expenses. So if you substitute all the values, you will get 1,33,000. This is liability based approach. This is calculating capital employed with the help of the items given on the liability side of balance sheet. So how much is capital employed? 1,33,000. Similarly, you have asset based approach. So under asset based approach, as I've already discussed, what is the formula for capital employed? It is fixed assets plus net working capital. So how much is fixed assets? 1,12,500 plus net working capital is nothing but current assets minus current liabilities. So how much is current assets? 55,500. Current liabilities is 35,000. So what's the answer? 1,33,000. As I've already discussed, whichever method you follow, the answer should be the same, whether it is asset-based approach or liability-based approach. So substitute the values in the formula. So it is 25,000 divided by 1,33,000 into 100, which is 18.79%. So with this, we'll complete this problem.